I'm very trusting as a person. I'd go into like my fittings with like designers and stuff, being like, hi, I'm on Drag Race. Mm. And I think people meant to use like code words, and I thought, let's not beat around the bush here. I need stuff doing. Hi, I'm Kitty Scott-Claus.
And I'm Elle of a Day.
And we are here with heat to spill our Drag Race secrets.
Ooh, shh. Yeah, I applied.
You have to apply.
Yeah.
I think even if you, I don't know, does anyone get like,
I don't know. I mean, they chased for a video. Did you apply for season two?
Yeah, I applied for season two.
I did the very first bit of the application for season two. I didn't do a video, but they did chase me for a video. So yeah. I feel like they maybe have an idea of who they want. I don't
and
know
also, this. Like when I, because I took a while, because I was like, I'm not going to rush, and like, I don't want to do my tape in a rush. I want to take my time and like enjoy the period of like making the tape. Because that was actually really fun. But awesome. I remember getting emails from them being like, hi, just checking out, like, how's your tape coming along? Yeah. So it was like...
See, I had a different experience. I rushed the tape, so it was really stressful.
Oh, God.
I was like, I need to get it done quickly, get it in. Yeah.
You take your time. Make them wait.
Well, listen, it worked.
It worked out. I applied for season two. I didn't apply for season one. I remember when it came out, when, like, season it announced like, oh, Drag Race UK. Mm. I remember thinking like, oh my God, like no way, I'm not ready for this. And I remember thinking like, there's so many people that I know like would be on, like in my head I was like, this is the first cast. Mm-hmm. Like this is the first season, so I didn't even apply for the first one.
Yeah, season three was the only one I applied for fully. Like I started the application for two and didn't finish it because what was I doing? Oh, I got hairspray. So I thought, I'm gonna do hairspray.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then 2020 happened.
And then didn't do hairspray.
Yeah.
Did Drag Race.
Right, yes, no, okay. Here's the thing. The drag scene in the UK is actually really small. Mm-hmm. And I feel like everyone knows everyone anyway. So yeah. The only people that I didn't know, the only person I didn't know that was going to be there was Elektra Fence. I hadn't clocked that she was there. But she got that I was there because we had to do 10 days isolation before in the hotel, and she wished me a happy birthday, and I thought she was trying to trick me out, so I didn't reply to her. And then she was like, I knew you were here.
Yeah. I knew most people. I'd never heard a charity case.
And
she had, no, never in my life. And she had the biggest following. I had no idea who she was. And I didn't know who Teresa was. And I'd seen most, like you said, London's small. Mm. And most of the queens from season three were from London. So I pretty much knew everyone. But I hadn't even met Kitty in real life.
No, we'd spoke online before, yeah. But...
And I wished her a happy birthday in isolation as well.
We had a very...
Hope you're having a lovely day.
Because I knew that you were like two doors down in the hotel. I remember being like, what are you up to?
And I just had this image in my head that she was sat on the end of the bed crying, eating a tuna baguette. Having a lovely birthday.
When we had the first call to be like, oh, you've been shortlisted. But then it like from that, it was like, you've got to pass your psych test, you've got to pass your background check. But I remember having that first call and just being like, I'm on.
Me too.
And then I got on with it. And then from the official, like, yes, the time they said like, you are confirmed, you are a member of the cast. It was like a month.
Yeah, the thing is, we were in the third lockdown as well. So I think they might have given us a little bit more time because there was no shops open. It was really, we weren't meant to travel, were we?
No.
Unless you had a reason to travel, you weren't meant to travel anywhere. So it was a bit of a nightmare.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I don't actually remember. I've forgotten all of that time, so it's so stressful.
It's blanked from your memory.
Yeah. I did at first, I only told my boyfriend Marco, but then my mum was worried about me that I had depression because I went quiet for 2 weeks. So I had to tell my mum.
Is that true?
Yeah, because I didn't want to tell anyone. I didn't want to tell my family. I wanted them to find out stupidly.
No!
When the show came
out. But you disappeared for like 2 months.
Well, listen, I just went quiet and my mum was like, hey, I'm glad you told me because I was really worried about you. See, I did keep it a secret as much as I could, but people just know, don't
they? Yeah.
People gossip, especially drag queens.
Mm-hmm. I think people gossip.
Yeah.
I kept it a secret for like maybe 5 minutes. But I say this, and in my head, I was telling like no one. I was keeping really, really like tight-lipped. And then we got to filming Drag Race, and absolutely everyone was like, we knew you were going to be here.
Mm.
And I was like, how? But...
Because you told everyone.
I told everyone. That's what happens when you tell people. I'm very trusting as a person. I'd go into like my fittings with like designers and stuff, being like, hi, I'm on Drag Race.
Mm.
And I think people meant to use like code words, and I thought, let's not beat around the bush here. I need stuff doing.
I was the same. I was like, I'm not going on holiday.
Let's move mountains here.
Make it cheap for me.
Come on.
Yeah.
I'm friends with Cheryl Hole from season I'm friends with Cheryl Hole from season one of RuPaul's Drag Race and Tace from season two. We're all from the same drag family. So I remember I got a lot of advice from there. And Cheryl literally, like, it was amazing. She was literally like, get in contact with this person, this person, this person. Tell them I've sent you. And yeah, she was brilliant. I couldn't have done it without her.
Yeah, I didn't really know anyone that did it before because it was only one season when we applied.
Yeah.
The only person I knew was Crystal. And I kind of asked her, I think I might have told her I was going on. So I had a brief call with her when I was in isolation.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, and she gave me some advice. She said to do Mystic Meg, and I'm glad I didn't. I'm glad I did Nigella instead, because that was bad advice, Crystal. We speak every day.
Every day.
Me and Kitty are in a WhatsApp group with Rue, Michelle.
And what's the name of the WhatsApp group? It's Rue's favourite.
Rue's favourite
girls of all time.
Yeah. Well, we didn't get to smell Rue because of the restrictions of COVID at the time.
2 metres
unfortunately. Away. Unfortunately. But he's so tall.
Yeah, that's the one thing that I remember taking away from it that I could not get over. I don't think I've ever seen someone that tall in real life, like out of drag, no heels or anything. It was just like... Yeah. And Rue said to me one day, Rue was like, you're very tall. And I was like, honey, look in the mirror. Like, yeah. I'm a
massive
grasshopper
massive
compared
man.
To you.
And in drag,
so tall.
We never saw Rue stood up, did we, in drag?
No.
But I can imagine she's very tall.
But stunning. So, and like, I remember thinking when we stood like facing her, just how clear her skin was.
Mm.
It was like, what the hell?
What are you eating?
How'd you do that? What are you having? Ew, what have you done to your face? I want it.
Oh, I mean, no, that was.
There were like conversations and like bits of funny bits between like the queens that obviously wouldn't have made the cut for the show because it wouldn't have made sense. But like, even the Dirty Rice thing, that was so funny. And it was like we were in like a holding room eating lunch and it was just so like organic. Mm. But then it became such a thing. And then like, I remember like RuPaul
saying
like
dirty
catching
rice.
Up on it. And we were like, what? This is so jokes. And when it's in the show, I feel like it didn't get like, the airs and graces it deserved because it was so funny. We like every time someone said it, we would just all laugh.
I wish there was cameras just following us all the time. I know that
like old that's school really Drag Race,
but like if you could see us backstage in the moments when we're not meant to talk to each other,
yeah,
they're almost the funniest because we know we're not meant to speak.
Oh yeah,
and then you're speaking and you're
because the Queen team who famously made an appearance on season four of Drag Race, who we love very, very much. They have a word called ice, and if they say ice, it's like, shut up. Like, you
talking.
Are not allowed to talk. And if it's hard ice, that's like...
No talking at all.
Absolutely zip it, mister.
No. There was moments like, after episode two, I didn't stop crying for about 14 hours. On the show, you didn't see me cry at all. Zero emotion, I'm fine. But in reality, I was a mess and I almost quit. There you go.
I remember episode two, I think it does come across in the show, but I'm a very positive person and I thought I'd won that challenge. And like, literally I was like, I've done it. I've won a repeater badge. I've already like beaten Cheryl's record. Cheryl never won a badge. And I remember like gassing myself up. I remember coming in from getting critiques and being like, well.
Very smarmy.
Very, very smug. Being like, well, I've won it. Like, there's no two ways around it. And then there was the face rack on the stage, but I wasn't even top two. I was just there like, you're safe. I was like, fantastic. Thanks for that. Talking when we weren't meant to talk. Yeah. A lot of people would talk when we were put on ice.
And sometimes you're talking about what sandwich you're going to have for lunch. And
be ice!
And be like, I'm talking about the sandwich that I want to eat for lunch!
Oh, also, we got very good at talking in code. We realised, we weren't allowed to talk about anything like show related, but then you'd put it in like context of another thing being like, oh my gosh, do you remember at Freedom when you walked out on and we would like we'd find ways of like talking about things on the show without letting people know about what we're talking about.
Sneaky, aren't we? Sneaky season.
If we go back for like All Stars or anything, they're going to be onto us now. They'll be like, no talking about anything.
We'll have like different winks that we can do.
Yeah,
they'll
or Morse
flirting.
Code. We can just. Ooh.
I think River got told off for talking a lot.
River got told off a lot. Veronica got told off a lot.
For being late all
Veronica
the time.
Veronica was always the last one to get ready.
Always so late.
Always very late. But I no, River remember. River and Scarlett are the ones. River and Scarlett?
Scarlett.
I think Scarlett was actually all right.
River
and Veronica, that's who I would say. They were the naughty girls.
We were quite good girls, weren't we?
Yeah, we did.
Yeah.
I've well.
You got some heat. Heat one, didn't you?
We were the heat magazine. Now. I got some. I got.
Oh, I stole about 10 wig heads.
Yeah, all the wig heads.
I got the Snatch Game card. I don't know if you got as well.
I got some straighteners, I got some curling tongs, and when we were packing up, they were filming UK versus the world the next day after we finished, and we were all like putting the wig heads in our bag, being like, haha, they'll never need these. Mm. And they were like, no, no, we need them back, we need them back. And we were like, why? What's going on? Yeah. What, and they were like, well, no, no, no. And then they were saying like, they were like, oh no, we're taking down the set now. We're taking down the set. We were trying to pack everything away. Yeah.
Meanwhile, they were changing they were, like, the photos.
Changing the photos and like like painting the floor. And they were like, we're packing it down. It's like, oh, it looks like you.
We weren't born yesterday.
Be filming
Wendy.
Something else.
It was Wendy. Wendy was saying, oh, we're packing down the set while they're changing RuPaul's picture for another RuPaul's picture.
Changing them round, putting the wig heads back up that we'd taken. No, we knew because Cheryl told me before I went away that she was going to be on it.
So we knew, and we're telling the Queen team that we knew, and they're like, no, no.
Don't know
and
what you mean.
I'd be like, what are you doing tomorrow, Lucy? Oh, I'm going to go home.
Going home. Driving
like,
home.
You're not though, are you?
I'm driving home. And I remember Cheryl saying to me after she got back, because we filmed the finale, and then the day after, we were doing our exit interviews, but whilst we were doing that, they were filming the first, like their entrances on the main stage, and they had these big monitors, and it shows what every camera's picking up on. And apparently Cheryl did her entrance, and she looked on the monitor, and she was like, oh, there's Kitty. And I was actually just there doing my exit interviews, like, out of drag, like, woo! Yes, there is. Yeah. There is a group chat. No,
everyone's in. Left, everyone.
And also, ours has a really boring name. Like, you listen to, like, the other girls saying, like, what their group chat was called, and ours is just the cast of season three.
Yeah, but then there's different, you know, there's different groups as well. You have to.
Yeah, you have to. You have to.
Pick a mix group. Yeah, we've got our own. Well, we've just got a chat, haven't we?
That's just a chat. That's just
me,
that's
you
just
and I.
WhatsApp.
That's just how WhatsApp works.
We talk, don't we? We got our chat on the go. Yes, but that's just a private.
That's a management chat. Ah, yes. That's it.
I didn't realise that Leanne from Little Mix followed me until the other day.
Oh, that's good.
And I was like, oh my God, as if. And then I was like, we met her on Drag Race, but still, like, that blows my mind.
I don't even know. I don't see fame.
Well, I follow you.
I don't see fame. I don't see age. I don't see you. You don't exist to me.
I'm trying to think. I've had some good ones. Like, Dawn French followed me on Twitter, and that was mad. I was like, what? Who else? Lily James, Cinderella. Oh my God, I love her.
Liz Truss follows me.
Does she actually?
Big fan.
Does she actually?
Yeah, big fan.
Oh, I wouldn't brag about that one, babe.
Of course she doesn't.
Oh.
I blocked her.
Oh.
She tried.
Oh.
Oh, lunchtime's always good.
I know, because they would get us M&S meal deals because we refused to eat the catering on the set because they would try and get us to eat like, right, we've got catered food. What is it? Jacket potato.
No, it'd be like a green Thai curry. And when you've got a corset on and you're boiling hot, you don't want to eat a Thai curry.
I'll have an egg and tomato sandwich from M&S, please.
Yeah, with tomatoes and salad cream.
I just said an egg and tomato sandwich, with tomatoes.
I don't hear. I think my favourite moment was Snatch Game or the comedy roast when we both excelled.
Yeah, that was...
Just because it was really, really scary, but it's like being shot out of a cannon and we just... like thrived under that pressure, I think.
Do you remember as well? I remember finding out like the day before we finished filming that because if we were like finishing late, they'd be like, oh, you can just get like food from the hotel and they'd get it for us. And I didn't realise that we were allowed to order like, I would just order like one thing off the menu and I was like, I want to eat vegetables. I've not eaten vegetables in so long. And they were like, you can. And I was like, oh. And then turns out everyone was ordering like starters and desserts and everything. And I was like a pauper with like a bowl of porridge. Like, I want some veg in my life. And meeting Baby Spice. Well, what a fantastic time.
Wowee, I've been Elle of a Day.
I've been Kitty Scott Claws.
And they were our Drag Race secrets.
Ooh.